It's piano day. My daughter Johnny Rose made this for me. I realized I need to do a couple piano days because I've got a few piano songs. I have a lot of piano songs. Most of them are ballads, so piano day will be, that's why I thought doing it on a Sunday would be good. Because Sundays are kind of chill, they're kind of relaxed, right? It's hard to tell when you're home every day now, but this is Sunday. Sunday always feels different to me. I always felt that wherever I went, I would always know when it was Sunday. Sunday just feels different. So it's Sunday and it's piano day. This piano that I'm playing on, I have had for, 31 years. My manager at the time, Bill Leopold, bought it for me. And it has he put a plaque on it that has the definition of maverick. It says maverick. Says a person not labeled as bringing in any, I suppose I would need some light on this. It's a great idea to read this, but anyway, it's got the definition of maverick on it. My wife's laughing. So it's really nice. It's a little, I'll take a picture of it later and show it to you. So yes, hi everyone. This has been amazing. It's been so much fun. I've been doing it on the guitar. Today is piano day. Had to move the whole setup. This is the room with all the guitars. I know, look. And those are only just a little bit of the guitars I have. And you have requested some piano songs. And the biggest request, of course, is a cover that I used to do of Joan Armatrading's song. Joan, I was a huge fan, and I used to do this song when I'd play in the bars in Long Beach in Pasadena, and a little bit in Pomona. I used to work in Pomona. That was my first gig in California. And I used to cover this song because I was a big Joan Armatrading fan. First time I heard her was in Boston. I just loved her as a songwriter. If you don't know her, look her up. It's Sunday. Go look up Joan Armatrading. Beautiful, beautiful songs. Beautiful songwriter. Just interesting, amazing. And this song, always really, really, it's one of those songs, oh, I wish I'd written that song sort of thing. And I remember doing it. I recorded it for something for VH1 in like 92 or 3. And she commented that she really liked it. And she doesn't like anything. She said she usually doesn't like when people cover her songs, but she liked it. So I got to meet her, and she's just a lovely, lovely person, and sending much love to Joan and her partner Maggie in London. She's a beautiful home in London. So this song, so many of us like this song, The Weakness in Me. Sort of person who falls in and quickly out of love, but to you I gave my affection right from the start. I have a lover who loves me. Such a heart, yet still you get my attention. Why do you come here when you know I've got troubles enough? Why do you call me when you know make me lie when I don't want to? Make someone else some kind of an unknowing fool. And you make me stay when I should not. Are you so strong, or is all the weakness just passing by, but I mean to see you. Brings back such memories. I just love that song, and I love how much you love that song. So thank you so much. Playing the piano, I taught myself how to play the piano. Sort of. I took the lessons from Mrs. Mathis in the next block. She taught all the kids in the neighborhood. And once I learned that I could apply what I knew on the guitar to the piano, I learned when I was about, I'd say 13. Then I went, I got this. And I kind of taught myself the rest. So if you put a big piece of piano music in front of me, I couldn't play it. But if I listen to something, I can play. And so that's how I play. I didn't have a piano for a long time when I was in Los Angeles. The first two albums don't have any piano on it. And it wasn't until the third album when I actually had this piano that I started writing on piano again, and all the other songs you hear have been written on this piano right here. But there was a song I wrote when I was home, when my father got us a piano, and I actually still have that piano. It's in the other room. But my mother had it for the longest time. And I wrote it when I was, I think I was about 16 years old, just, 15, 16, just starting to blossom and become a living, loving person in my teens. And I wrote the song, and I always liked it. And I got brave my first couple of tours, and I played it live a couple of places. I would play it like as the encore sometimes. And a few of you have always remembered that, those of you who saw me back then, especially my fans in Germany. Hello, superfan Tim. And so here goes that song. It's so it the lyrics are so simple because I was much younger, and it's always a little embarrassing to play a song. I mean, how about those poems you wrote when you were 16? You want to share those? So it's a little, you know, but I trust you when you all say you like the song. So I'm going to do the song now for you. It's called Ready to Love.
Ready to love. I
Don't forget to tip your waiters and waitresses. I always, when I play piano, I feel very loungy. I feel very, because I used to play more piano when I played in Boston. I played in a steakhouse. It was a seafood restaurant run by a steakhouse, Ken's Steakhouses, but it was Ken's by George. It was a seafood restaurant, go figure. It's actually really good. And I'd play, you know, Barry Manilow songs and stuff. But I made a living singing. Boston, hello Boston, if you're there. Hope you're all doing good. How you doing, wife, behind the camera?
I'm good. Is everyone happy with the sound?
Is everyone happy with the sound? Can you hear my voice? Because we don't have the professional setup yet. We're still just using the phone.
Lots of applause.
So lots of applause lots for the applause. Sound. Good. Good, good, good.
Oh, Lynn Gleam says it's awesome. So
okay.
We love you, Lynn.
Well, I hope you all are doing good, sitting at home and staying at home, because that's what we need to flatten the curve. I hope this brings some joy into your day.
Hi, Charlie.
I love Charlie. We had to cancel our... Charlie was going to have me speak to his kids at school. Charlie's an amazing teacher, and hello to all the teachers. My father was a teacher. That is a special job. Those are special people who are teachers. You do an amazing service to the world. Think about all the teachers that made a difference in your life. That's how wonderful teachers are. So big shout out to the teachers on Sunday. And it must be hard not being able to teach the kids, you know, the way you like, and not knowing what the year's going to look like. I know we all do. That's why we have to be to in the moment, taking it day by day, just in the now, right here. So that's what we're doing. And music is a great thing to be in the now with. Here is a song from the Lucky album. Now, Lucky album was a critical time for me. It was the beginning of the 2000s. I started writing it around 2001, 2, right around there. And my wife's changing my lighting. She's always a TV person.
Well, because the outside is changing.
It's all good. I know, I appreciate you. You are my production crew. I'd like to thank my crew, my director, my producer, my lighting designer, my sound engineer.
Oops.
Oh, who hit the camera? That was my crew, my wife. Who is, you know, there's nothing like knowing how your relationship is to spend all day in the home thing, day after day after day after day after day.
No, oh, it's... a lot of teachers are watching.
Oh, good. Lots of teachers. Love
and
that.
Nurses.
And nurses. Now, yesterday was Nurses Day. Nurses, thank you. Thank you for all that you're doing. And whatever you're doing, wherever you are, thank you. And everyone, you know, just send that love out. Send it in to yourself. Give yourself lots of love. Say, I'm loving myself today. Anyway, this song was on Lucky. And Lucky was a little difficult for me. It was sort of after the 90s, you know, after the big, I had, you know, top five albums and, you know, selling millions and millions, and the music industry started to change, and my record company wasn't the same anymore, it was different people, and they were saying, we don't hear a hit, and it was all that stuff that really kind of brings me down about the music industry, the business part. You know, it's the music business. But I, you know, I did my best, and one day I just went, dang, I want to go write a song for me and for those fans that I know go out and immediately get my album, get the piece of music that I've created for them, and they put their headphones on or they jump in their car and they listen to it and they want to be moved. And so I wrote on this piano. I sat down and in a day actually wrote this song about, it's about Kansas. It's about wanting to leave Kansas. It's about being different in Kansas. I love Kansas, love my hometown. But it's called Meet Me in the Dark. Keep to yourself. they've been saying, and you knew all along that I would have to go find a place where light shines on my reflection, a place where I can stand up on my own, not down on my knees. Until then, please meet me in the dark, meet me in the shadows, past the old graveyard, down Eisenhower Road, meet me where the storms blow out on their own, dear, meet me in the dark, never let me go. I know everyone has their unspoken fear, it eats away their senses and their humanity. They carry all their secrets every night down to the river, and they try so hard to drown them. They won't do that to me, 'cause I'm working hard, saving all my money, and the tips in this jar buy a brand new set of wings for my Mercury. Until then, please meet me in the dark, meet me in the shadows, past the old graveyard, down Eisenhower Road. Thank you.
This is where you give people a moment to wipe their tears and applaud. Okay, now you can go.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Oh, see, piano day is mellow because I'm not kind of a piano rocker. Don't do a lot of that.
Did you tell everyone there's a 2-drink minimum and a cover charge?
Yes, I'm sure they paid the cover charge.
Okay, good.
Make sure to tip your waiters and waitresses. Yeah. Oh, and all you waiters and waitresses out there and people in the service industry, we are hit hard, I know. Don't worry, stay in the now. Stay right now. Because the minute this is over, we are all gonna get together and cuddle up so much. I miss people. I miss you. I watch movies and things. I'm like, look at them. They're all so close. They're all touching each other. Look at that. They're all hugging each other. I can't wait to do that again. We need that. This is not natural.
We have a lot of the cruisers saying hi.
Hi.
And hopefully we'll do that.
As of now, the cruise is absolutely on. It's in October. This is all going to be cleaned. All going to be done by then. So October. And for other tour dates, as we roll along, I know some of them are still selling. We're kind of, you know, we're hopeful. I will let you know. You know the ones that have been canceled, definitely for next week and the next week. But I'll let you know as soon as I know, because, you know, we of course want to come to your town. But until then, we're here and we're doing this. All right, one more song for you.
Someone said they're way past the 2-drink minimum.
It is. I don't blame you. Especially in Europe, it's 11 o'clock there. It's 10 o'clock in London. And I have no idea what time it is in New Zealand. It's tomorrow in New Zealand and Australia.
And you have your t-shirt. Lucky Taco.
Oh, I wonder if they're on. Otis and Sarah, my Lucky Taco t-shirt. Ah, the Lucky Taco.
It's a restaurant. You want to explain that?
Oh, it's a... of course I do. I want to explain that. It's a taco truck in New Zealand. Auckland, New Zealand. If it's got the greatest tacos in the world. Now my mouth is watering because I want Lucky Taco tacos.
By our friends
Otis and Sarah, and they're two of the kindest, most amazing human beings on earth. Okay, I need a little lyric for this because Mama doesn't do this song enough. I should. You think I would sing this every night to my beloved?
Aww.
I know. I got married. It's almost 6 years now.
You're married?
Yes. To you.
Oh.
Married in May. May 31st is our wedding anniversary. And I surprised my wife by, I wrote a song and I recorded it. She didn't know I recorded it. I was recording This Is Me at the time. And I recorded the song, didn't tell her about it. And then I hired a string quartet they wrote a chart up for it. And so for my vows, I sang this to her. Now, I have never sung to anyone looking straight in their eyes and singing. It was very powerful, very intense, but I got through it.
Have you ever had Melissa Etheridge sing a song to you, straight in your eyes? So there.
So my sweet wife, I sang this to her, and then we gave the song away as a parting wedding gift. And I still feel this way. I remember sitting down to write this song, and I was first writing a love song to her, because there's nothing like feeling great, amazing love, and then writing a love song, because that's. And then I realized, as I was going through the song, that I was writing about being standing in the aisle and getting married, and what that meant after us LGBTQ. I know you're not all gay, but you know, lots of gays out there. Hating my gays, and just we've worked so hard just to be married, you know, and finally when it came through and we were allowed to be legally married by the state of California and the United States, it was really special. So I wrote this song, and to those of you who have used it in your wedding, lots of people tell me that, or that it's your song. Just much love to you all. You know what, and and feel love, keep love. That's what's going to really, really get us through this, is to just remember love, create love, think love, drink love, you know, just create more love than fear. That's what this is all about, because we are creating a new world now that we're going out into. And so I just say keep loving and keep, you know, we're under very stressful times, so that relationships can become stressed. So do not worry. Just every night, go to bed, kiss, get up in the morning, I love you, and just do your best every single day. And here is Who Are You Waiting For? I did not fall when you found me. I was face down, my confidence small. Pushed off the merry-go-round, wishes and horses and all the king's men could not put my heart back together again. I'm through with love, isn't it clear, my friend? You said, who are you waiting for? You said, who are you waiting for? Broken. Smile. I don't have to go this alone.